Live from Detroit.
Pink suits with hats to match. Big crocodiles and Cadillacs. You looking for the fattest sacks. This is where it's at. Windows tinted. Seats for the recline. Keep your hands on the burner.
Yo, yo, what up, though? It's your man, Jay Johnson, a.k.a. the tinfoil hat titan, a.k.a. the conspiracy realist, a.k.a. the phone racist. Oh, no, y'all fucking my intro up. a.k.a. I only debate my equals, all those else I teach.
What's that an acronym for? I've heard that before.
There's no acronym, just facts.
All right. I'm just too hot for that. And this is Dame Going Wild, Mouth of the Midwest, Pride of Puritan Avenue, the David Ruffin, the Shop Talk Podcast. You know who they came to see.
Nice like this. Just don't end up like that. All right, man.
Cocaine is probably really not.
Have you done coke today, dog?
Nah.
What's going on, man?
That's probably about coke and heroin is coke, heroin, and meth. Those are three drugs I can't fuck with.
Man, how was your week, man? What's going on, dog? Please tell these people what's wrong with you, dog.
That's wrong. I'm having an incredible week. It's Christmas. Santa Claus is still alive. Jesus was not born in December either. I can't wait for Christmas to be over and the new year to be over with, too. I just want to see bowl games.
Man, bowl game shit week.
I don't get into Christmas. I don't like it. I don't put up a Christmas tree. It's just
I ain't put up a tree
Sunday.
In a while. Man, you got kids. You got to get into Christmas.
Nope, I don't. I ain't put up a Christmas tree in like 4 years.
I mean, the tree is one thing, but they want gifts. They want, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Like I mean, they're going to have, like, they got gifts on gifts, but, and I'm not putting up a tree. I don't want Christmas celebrated at my house. I'm just not in the spirit, dog. I don't like the holidays.
Scrooging it up.
I mean, I don't want to have to fake it, because that's what people do, like,
don't
in the month
it.
Of December. They be ass bags all year long, and then fucking the holidays come around and everybody want to act nice. Like, you've been a bitch all year. All year. 12 months.
Okay.
So.
You had a bad day today.
Just fucked the holidays, man. I ain't into that shit.
Hey, it's Christmas time, man. I just look forward to Christmas breakfast with my family. That's all I really care about. Christmas breakfast, that's like the biggest thing in our family every year. So.
Do y'all ride past the Whooping House on Christmas?
Hey, dog, don't bring up the Whooping House no more.
Ah, oh, man.
All right, man. So some crazy shit went on this week, man.
All right, let's get into it. The nigga that got shot.
All right, so it's time for me. If we're going to start this shit off really, really early, I'll put my tinfoil hat on and my conspiracy hat on. We all seen this footage on CNN of the Russian Turkey ambassador who got assassinated live on television, allegedly. This man got shot 8 times with no blood, nowhere. Like, how is that possible? I don't understand.
Because it's all movie magic. Like, that's what that shit is. But even on, like, SUV, like, if a nigga gets shot, he bleed out.
Like, and he laid on the ground. They put the camera on him. Of course, you didn't actually see the shots. You just saw a guy screaming Allahu Akbar or some bullshit for the media, and everybody just ran.
Remember a couple months back when they found that, like, they were financing some studio to make all them videos?
That's exactly what it looked like.
Like, it just felt like some movie shit.
Like, nigga, you got shot 8 times in the back, and then you landed on your back. It seemed like if you got shot 8 times in the back, you would fall forward.
Yeah.
This nigga laid on his back, clothes perfectly fine, no bullet holes in the clothes, no blood, and just what looks like to be a white man screaming, Allahu Akbar.
It's movie mad. It's all bullshit. It's the overlay for the other shit that's going to come after Trump get in office.
And what else happened? Your men's or your people's was on the Delta flight?
Yeah, I think that was some setup shit.
Yeah, so originally I seen this video on this guy. He looked just slightly familiar, saying that he was kicked off of the plane. Like, oh my God, it's 2016. We've been kicked off the plane because we're speaking. I said a word to my mom in Arabic or whatever. And people was very upset. Some people in their seats was clapping, waving goodbye, get out of here, and all the other bullshit. And it turns out he's a YouTube prankster, and he sets up different scenarios and shit like that. So this is where I'm at with it.
Getting kicked off the plane is going a bit extreme. I know somebody that got kicked off a plane and they on the no fly list now. So I mean, I wouldn't kind of want to play around with that shit.
So here's the thing. So I don't know if it was a whole thing with stage, right? Mm-hmm. But would you call it fake if it was staged?
Scripted, maybe. Like,
yeah, because the
like, people, like Love and Hip Hop, reality TV.
Right. So you got a staged set with real people, because the people in the plane was happy because he was allegedly speaking another language. He got kicked off like that. You can't fake that. Like, that's real.
Yeah. Yeah. It's fucked up though, and I don't want to get kicked off a plane, because like, if
I wouldn't care.
You say that till you can't fly no motherfucking where, and then you give a damn.
I take a train.
Nigga, get the fuck out of here. You know how long it take you from get from here to Cali on a train? From here anywhere on the West Coast on a train, nigga, that's like 4 days. It took me 6 hours to get from downtown to Chicago on a fucking train.
I ain't never been on a train, to be perfectly honest, so I have no idea. In my brain, it could be fucking utopia in that bitch. Never been on a train.
What? Like, that shit doesn't even make sense. Why the fuck not?
Like, what the fuck? Like, we ain't Detroit, no trains around this motherfucker.
I mean, nigga, they avoid. Like, you ain't never went out of town with your girl? Like, y'all go to.
I got a car.
Okay, I mean.
I've just never been on a train. So.
I'm gonna need you to culture up a little bit. Like, a train is
You just explained to me how fucking horrible the experience was, and then you told me to culture up. That sounds like a boss down.
Do something different. It's not the Greyhound.
Shit, I've been on a Greyhound a few times.
Hey, man, I know a motherfucker that took the Greyhound from here to Texas.
Fuck off. For $13 and a... Yeah.
I left a nigga on the Greyhound when I was like 14, 15.
What's worse, the Greyhound or the Megabus?
Greyhound. I take that Megabus all day.
That Megabus be like $4. You go from here to Chicago and...
I take the Megabus all day. The Greyhound is not that shit. For real.
All right, man. We got a couple guests in the building, man.
And they's taking selfies and shit and been...
Let's introduce everybody in the room.
Before
please.
We do all that, I just want to bring to the attention, he got on a dad
hat. Did you say a dad hat?
Come on, man. Like, y'all gonna stop coming at me. I've been defending my boy.
Hey, respect
like,
my crown.
Okay, I'm gonna talk about you because you've never been on a train.
Really? Well, I ain't never been on a train.
Never been in New York, just not even a subway. No.
I was going to New York, I was a kid, and we drove.
You run to Chicago on a train, it's 5 hours. It's actually cool.
It is a fun experience. Even if you're in maybe Toronto or something, you gotta get on a train.
You never took the train to Carolina?
Mm-mm.
Oh, you're so lying.
Sorry.
I never took the train there either.
You
gotta talk in the microphone.
Oh, I never took the train there either.
Back in the day, I used to take the train to Carabana.
Yeah. Well, so where the train station they go to Canada?
It's
downtown.
You gotta go
right
on downtown.
No, but the one, yeah, and in Canada, you gotta go to Windsor.
Who knew?
Right on the other
side. Amtrak train.
You can see it.
Only time I go to Canada when I was like 19 so we can drink. Ain't shit in Canada that I want.
Well, I see
Canada's
Carabana
full of beautiful ass women.
True that, true that. I never been to the Caribbean. I was one thing. I still want to go.
One second. You used to go to Canada. What club did you hit up? Don Cherry's?
Speaking to the microphone.
Oh, you used to go to Don Cherry's?
I don't know what the fuck that is, but I feel like you're throwing shade at me, so I'm going to be disrespectful at you.
I went to Don Cherry's.
I don't know what that is.
The music room.
No, it was the music cafe.
Yeah, music cafe.
Upstairs.
Who the fuck remembers names? I was a kid drinking underage.
That place used to slap memories. You remember the River Rock?
Of course. I remember Detroit shit.
Jason, do you dance?
Dance?
Do you know how to dance?
Come on.
No, I don't dance.
Come on. I want y'all to stop right
niggas
now.
Niggas from my neighborhood don't dance.
Oh, what is that?
No. I want y'all to stop right now.
We don't dance. Introduce yourselves.
Well, my name is Tina, and I am a guest of Nina from Everyday Ignorance. So thank you for inviting me here today.
Is that the set you claiming?
Everyday Ignorance?
Yeah, okay. I'm her guest.
That's our podcast beef, if y'all remember from the last week.
I'm sorry. Well, I'm still her guest.
I thought the beef was still on because we haven't. She gave us like terms of how to end it, and we've made no attempt to end the beef.
Hey, I don't squash the beef.
I'm not in the beef.
You accomplice accessory. If the police come, you're going to jail too. What's your name?
Damn.
What up? It's Nina. I'm back. Are you guys following my podcast? Are you guys listening to my podcast, Everyday Ignorance? Check it out. It's very interesting. I have a lot of, you know, hot topics going on. And I'm here to kick it with these clowns. You know, even though, you know, Jason's been a hater. He's been hating on my podcast. I know y'all know.
She did say you was a hater. And that's why you weren't there. for her birthday.
I wasn't invited.
He was no, because he didn't send in his list.
Oh, okay.
Hey, man, I forgot. I really did.
I reminded you three times.
Once, but I still did forget.
And
after
then she had
me.
Damon tell you too, or unless he lied.
Now that might be where the problem is.
That might be the breakdown.
That might be
Damon. I got the proof.
Dame, don't forget.
You told me to. You told me to.
Yeah.
Send
it. Yeah. Yeah. We talked.
Okay.
We talked.
We talked.
Okay.
I knew it was some light skinned nigga.
My bad. Yeah, it was my fault.
I knew it was some light skinned nigga. Didn't I tell you that? But we had the wrong light skinned.
I'm 100% Zulu. Just in case you don't know.
I thought it was the one pretending to be light skinned. It was really the light skinned one.
Okay.
Oh.
It's going to be a long episode.
Very.
I knock all these mics over.
You just ruined the room.
And our final guest.
I'm TJ. I'm an old hoe from long ago.
Oh, my God. Oh my God.
They didn't pull me out the woodworks. They didn't know what they was getting into. Jay, I know you don't know me like this, but you about to the deck.
Well, we got a bunch of different topics that y'all not gonna agree with.
Okay.
So we, you know,
I don't know. I'm pretty chauvinistic. I'm old school.
I'm okay. I'm okay with that.
We'll see.
Like a man should pay all the bills type of old school.
Absolutely.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So which one? Babe, all look at our list. Which one? Where do I start?
I wouldn't say all of them. I would say like the household bills, because like in my situation.
So hold on.
My husband pays all the bills.
Talking to the mic, Nina. That's why it's in front of you.
Like in my situation, my husband pays all the household bills, but I have to pay my personal bills. Like
you got to pay for shit for you. Oh
yeah, like my debt, my credit card, my cell phone,
your car note.
My car note, but I got rid of the car insurance.
What you mean you got rid of the car insurance?
You dropped it.
He pays my car insurance.
Oh, because you just don't
Because technically that's a household bill, because if somebody hit me, they're going to sue the house. They're not going to sue me. They're going to sue us.
They're going to sue your insurance company.
That's if you pay it, because I'm going to let it go.
They get the money from your car insurance company.
And then you want to cheat on Dwayne and he take good care of you like that?
I am not.
You cheating on your husband?
Shit. I am not about to leave my husband right now. Once I go to Miami, if I run into Bumani Jones, what's up, Boo? I mean,
she was serious about that shit. She was serious about that shit.
He's on my list though, so technically I could fuck him and still be married.
About to say, did he make the
He's
list?
On my pass list.
Let's hear this pass list. And how many names can be on the pass list?
Four.
That's a weird ass number. It was really three, and you added somebody to the fucking list.
Probably.
That's just a weird number. Four.
Yeah, I did do that.
Because the pass list seemed like it should be short. One or two.
Like, I got 19 names on my pass list and shit. Like, no, that's not.
That's some shit.
But it's his fault, though, because I hate sports, and he be forcing me to sit there and watch SportsCenter. So the more and more I kept looking at the nigga, he was looking good, and he's been looking good. And then when I, looked into him,
all right,
he's my type of guy.
From highly questionable Bumani Jones.
I like the show. I watch it every day.
Isn't he entertaining? Them teeth.
Sometimes he'd be trolling sometimes.
I think Dan Le Batard and Poppy are funnier.
Yeah.
What?
Sometimes I like Bowani, right? Yeah, he represents for us most of the time. Sometimes I think he take the I gotta take this stance because I work for ESPN. I'd be like, I know you don't really feel this way. Like,
oh, he get his coon on.
I won't go that far. I won't go that far. He ain't Stephen A out here, but sometimes I don't agree.
Stephen A. Smith certified coon, dog. I can't
fuck
with him.
Stephen A. Smith.
And who's it? And Chris Broussard.
With Chris Broussard.
I don't like Broussard.
I like when he stood up for his own. He stood up for when he said he don't support the gays or some shit. You know, you really can't say that in public. And they tried to come for him, and he stood by it. He wouldn't back down. And he stood by his little Bible and all that other good shit. He would not back down. And he ain't get fired either. So I fuck with him for that.
Okay, well, I mean, if you
it's hard not to once they put that shit on you, pause. Hey, it's hard to fight them niggas off. So,
all right, well, whatever. I don't like that nigga Chris Broussard. So, just back to the topic. You feel like your husband should pay all the household bills, including your car insurance.
Yep.
So your bills ain't adding up to that much though.
So let me ask a question then.
And if he fall on his knuckles, like, you gonna help him bounce back?
Yeah, like if it's a situation like that, he get laid off or he lose his job. I mean, I don't recommend it, but I mean, if things happen, and if it happened to happen.
Nah, we not recommending it, but this is like your husband.
No. Hold on. We have to clarify. It depends on why you lost your job. Now, if you lost your job for doing something stupid, I can't support that.
Yeah.
I ain't with you. So the house going to die because I did something stupid and I lost my job?
Everybody do
no,
something.
The house going to find another daddy.
Yeah, you're so not being responsible.
So if the man is paying all the bills and everything like that, like what exactly is your role? What do you bring to the table? Like, why should I have you instead of just a random person?
Because I'm fucking me. Fuck. I'm me.
So nothing. So you don't have an answer?
No, like, I mean, like companionship, you know, morals.
Companionship with a dog.
No, moral support, you know, sex, shit like that. You
so
can't
sex,
have sex with a dog.
So sex,
you can't
essentially.
Have sex with a dog.
We know. I mean, I hope.
We're not having that okay. type of podcast. Yeah.
please. I mean, you can.
But really, though, like, so, you know, like, so this is all the things that my husband does for me, and this is what I do for him. Like,
I mean,
is
I
it
clean
just...
up the house, and I mean, I do stuff. I mean, I do a lot. I deal with him. You know, I fall in the toilet at least twice a week because he won't put the fucking toilet seat down.
Do you leave it up?
After 10 years.
Who? Do I leave it up?
Yeah, like after you pee, do you leave the toilet seat
no.
up?
No.
Why not?
Because we back into it. You walking into it. You can see what you coming to. We back into it.
Yeah. What? That's why you fall in the toilet. Sense. You need to look at it before you turn it around and back up on it. Why would you look at it?
You're going backwards.
Look at
you. Look while you walk.
Hold on. I've never been into a bathroom in the toilet. Like I have to turn in the direction of the toilet seat. So again, you have to turn your ass in the direction of the toilet seat, which means at some point
maybe
you walk toward. No, no. Come on. If you walk in backwards,
you
deserve to fall into the toilet. You, if you walk in backwards, you deserve to fall into the toilet.
I just think that women should leave the toilet seat up.
Well, first of all, it's nasty. First of all, it looks bad. Yeah. It's not even
it's
about
it's only if you got
bad.
A dirty toilet, it looks bad.
I don't care how clean your toilet. Y'all, men, y'all going to have something dribble somewhere.
It takes
2 seconds
to move your hand after you shake and just hit it and go back down.
Yeah.
I just can't do that.
Why don't y'all just leave it up when y'all finish?
Okay, but.
Because that ain't the way your mama raised you.
I'm just saying.
Raised don't you. Like,
but okay, after the just one, when you're doing a two, don't you push it down to take a seat?
Absolutely,
so
but I look at it first. I don't just don't back up into the shit
and
hope
up.
That it's down.
Then
I look at the fucking toilet
and then I put it back up because I pee more than I shit. So most of the time it's going.
Your mama didn't raise you like that.
Exactly.
I bet you your mama raised you to put the toilet seat down.
And I don't even have to meet Miss Johnson.
Is down in her house.
I bet you it is. That's the bottom line. Some shit just is. Put the toilet seat down.
Okay.
We'll hold on to that for later.
Some shit just is.
Okay.
Thank you. That might be a reoccurring theme. I just
want you to hold on to that theme because that's going to come back later.
Yeah.
Amen. God just opened it up for us just like that.
Look at him.
Won't he do it?
All right, man. Wait, so you don't feel you should pay bills or what you think you're supposed to be feeding?
No, I was just asking questions.
Okay, well, I'm going to jump in on this one because I'm in a situation, but I guess I've never felt that I wanted my husband to just pay all the bills, to say the least. Like, mm-hmm. I don't know. Maybe I think differently from other women because I have my godson's mother. She says if a man moves into her house, similar to what Nina said, that he should pay all of the bills. And I just feel like
I move into your house,
well, maybe not move in, or even if we just are together, like he should pay all the bills. And I feel like women who come with a handout, I feel like you get a little bit shortchanged because mm-hmm. I feel like you leave the man to always have the upper hand. Like I've always had a great job, I always contribute to the household, I pay the bills that I feel like I want to control the money. So give me your money and I'm gonna pay the bills. And I just feel like you
but
are in
does
more
that
control.
Still mean that he pays all of them? Just
he doesn't pay all
money.
Of them. No, I have a nice even split.
Well, in my situation, I earn this because I do get what Tina is saying in regards to coming with your hand out. When I met my husband, he was working at Bed Bath & Beyond. He was still in school. He was not making what I was making. So
you were shooting in the gym.
Basically, I was rolling dice. I was making an investment.
So
like I'm gonna go ahead and mess with you, and
so
we gonna see if you really graduate and do all these things you say you gonna do.
So there's two
now
different things,
all,
right?
Okay.
So it's definitely a possibility that a woman may make more than a man, right? But does that mean that this man can't take care of himself? So say he's making more money, but he still got his own place, got his own car, he's living his life. Just because you make more, like I'm still living my life. If I make $100,000 and you make $250,000. I still make $100,000 a year. I'm still perfectly fine. So just because you make more, it doesn't really mean that like you did someone a favor. Like I'm living my life.
No, but in my situation, my husband was still living at home when I met him.
Well, you know, you do make questionable decisions.
Yeah, he was still living at home because he was still in school. So I took him out his parents' house, you know, brought him with me. I was paying all the bills, and I was doing all that, all of that. But the agreement was, once your ass walk across that motherfucking stage, shit will change.
Once and, I get on, we on.
Yeah, and up. I need a break. I want money.
Okay, well, that's good. See, yeah, you've never explained that whole story. So I mean,
it was
now,
just like, yeah, I'm the shit. I'm don't me. Care. Pay my bills.
Yeah, now I feel my a little turn. Bit differently about okay. that, so that's fine.
Pick me.
Go ahead.
Like I said, I'm an old hoe from long ago. I was raised by my grandmother. My grandmother sat down and told my husband, I hope you can take care of her because I married three times for money and I ain't never been broke. And she learned to count by counting money.
It seemed like two other niggas went broke before the third one.
Well, she outlived them. She's outlived three husbands.
Damn. Killed them. She murdered them. Your grandma murdered them. Your grandma murdered them.
They all died in natural causes.
They didn't have autopsies.
R.I.P. to all my granddaddies.
They didn't have autopsies back then.
R.I.P. to all my granddaddies. But, plus adding all the times I done killed him at Comcast, but that's nothing. So, I believe that the man should be the head of the household in regards to finances, because more often than not, the woman is the head, is the CEO of the household. She handles all of the children. First of all, she's usually going to be the first one to get called if the kids get sick. She's usually going to be the first one to call off if something happens to the kids.
Is that because they are the best suited, or that's just because what we normally do is call the mom?
It just is. Right. Because usually that's what happens.
That's two different things, though. Right.
Because usually the mother, because that's usually what happens. If the kids are sick and somebody has to take off, it's usually the mother. If the kids come to mama first, usually, and then daddy. Helping with the homework, doing the domestic parts of the things, and those things are not measurable in dollars and cents. The cleaning up and the, you know what I mean? The cooking and the nurturing that, that a woman gives can't be measured in dollars and cents. While daddy don't be too loud, because daddy on the couch watching the football game. He want to watch the ball game. You know what I'm saying? So that's the payoff.
That's just common courtesy.
It's also a stereotype.
It's a stereotype, but it happens to be the norm.
That's common courtesy. You want people out while you watching.
My father he didn't watch sports.
Sports, whatever he decided to do. Usually men are just not as hands-on with the upbringing of the household as the women are.
Okay, but what if you don't have children?
Oh, my child is grown. Nope. And in my house, we still...
So you just man and wife, but there's no children to do the... I got to take off work because the kid's sick. Then what? Like, so all that extra stuff that you...
But there's still... But then the woman still usually does most of the cooking and the cleaning and the handling of the bills and the handling of the household, or taking off work if the hot water tank goes out or the air conditioner.
Hot water tank goes out, husband at the crib. Because women don't know what the fuck is going on. Cable
I'm not
coming.
Saying they're fixing it.
I'm saying they're going
to
be...
I need to be there to oversee the
right,
shit.
Right, the woman, the wife is not being there when
if you don't know how to fix it, what the fuck are you overseeing?
Right, what you need to oversee?
To make sure he ain't fucking around in my basement.
I write the checks.
But I think also, if it's a situation where the woman's controlling the money, I don't care like how you say it, you're spending his money first.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
So he's still paying all the bills. That's just what a man is supposed to do. Like, that's your role. Know your role.
That's cool.
So pay all the bills.
So don't be a bitch nigga.
From what I'm hearing, there are definitely gender roles. Then we are okay with gender roles?
Yep. Okay. No. Because I don't cook.
Time out. Wait a minute. How is the man supposed to pay and you ain't supposed to cook? What's your role? Like, what's your benefit to the man?
I wish I could see her blinking.
As if cooking is worth whatever, you know, but
right,
like
X amount of $1,000 a year. I don't cook.
But what? So what's your?
But you are going to supply a meal when I.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna make sure that you eat. See, my support is one of my role is one of support. I'm gonna bring you from here to here,
spiritual.
Absolutely, that too. I'm gonna take you from here to here. I guarantee you, when if this ever ends, you came from here and now you're gonna end up there.
You're going to be better.
Better than what
you're
going to
graduate. Okay.
That sounds great, but how, like, tell me how you do that. Like, I don't know what that means. I hear you, but I don't know what that means.
Whether it's it's supporting you and encouraging you to go, encouraging you to go to school or what at spirit, like you said, spiritual, going to church, whatever the case may be. I'm there. Whatever you need, best friend, shooter, whatever you need, I'm there.
You seem insecure. I'm going to be your bank teller. You's doing such a good job. You that nigga.
You seen what happened to the bank teller?
She got fucked like she deserved.
that's the example you want to use?
Is she got fucked just how she deserved.
Am I the only one that's hot?
Yes.
If there's...
it may I'm be sorry. The...
Y'all really not?
No, I'm straight, and I. It's that Hennessy.
That's what took my clothes.
Okay. They trying to make me feel like I have the flash and shit.
You good?
So there's a mixed bag here. So I heard that the man is supposed to do these things, and there's definitely his role. Mm-hmm. And half said they are okay with gender roles, and the other half says no. So it sounds like you gave the man a role, but you're not actually taking a role.
That's right.
And that's where the double standard or the, that shit come in. That's like.
There's always double standards.
It's a double standard.
Y'all can fuck a million bitches and still be no
in love
nothing.
With your wife.
No, can I explain why that? I really hate that.
If I fuck a million bitches, I'm a
let me explain this.
I have an explanation as well. I'll let you go first.
It irritates me when I hear that shit though. So it's one, two things that's going on. One, men who are quote unquote celebrated by other men, I don't know why y'all aspire for that. Like you want your other women to say, hey, you had sex with a bunch of men. Hey, I don't understand why that's what you want to aspire to. But the real thing is, and where I kind of think it comes from is, one, contrary to proper belief, it's not easy for the average man to just go out here and have sex with whoever he wants to. Like niggas may lie on their dick, man. Niggas want to say whatever they want to.
Have you been on Tinder?
Let me get this shit out first, and then y'all can disagree.
Well,
right?
Then you're doing it wrong. I can fuck any bitch I want to.
I'm not the average man, okay? What I'm saying is, a woman can go out no matter what she look like, she can go out right now, go to a club, and find some man that will have sex with her. A man on every night cannot 100% go out and say, I'm bringing home a woman tonight. Not every man, not the average man.
$40.
All right, but listen, what I'm saying is...
Not from Backpage or from Woodward and Six
Mile. Regular,
I'm talking about for free.
A regular person I meet, whatever.
Buy a drink.
And I think some of that comes from because men who are not able to get women easily will see somebody who has all the women, all the things, like, damn, this nigga knows something I don't know. And I think they kind of gravitate that, and that's why they give them praise. And then y'all look at it like, well, all y'all do... Or like, if you're in a relationship with a man, you just assume every woman that he comes in contact with, he didn't have sex with, or every time somebody in his phone, like, it's not, y'all have like a false sense of what really goes on.
So are you saying that these niggas ain't fucking all these bitches?
Man, niggas be lying like a motherfucker.
Well, yeah, because a lot of them is suffering from erectile dysfunction.
No, I don't got nothing to do with that shit. I don't know about that. But everybody who
Tinder,
out there saying they got,
fish.
I done had sex with a thousand people, they be lying. Some.
I can't deal with you in this ED.
You know what? I don't know about that, Jay, because it depends on how good your game is.
Everybody don't got
there
game.
There are niggas that I fucked just because they was fine. I don't do that no more. I'm too old for that. But it was niggas
because they had braces.
It was literally niggas that I fucked just because I wanted to fuck them.
Okay.
Like, literally, I looked at you and was like, damn, he fine. I'm going to fuck him. Period. But... it was the game, but then I got...
So how many percentage of men in the world you just look like, damn, he's so fine, I'm on the fuck? That's not everybody, right?
No, not me.
See, I'm just saying in general.
You don't want to use this treasure box because this is a moneymaker. I don't do that.
Oh, so you're speaking hypothetically.
That was a long time ago.
Hypothetically.
Well, in my past life.
Okay.
I'm just saying...
Before you found the Lord or
I think I think women give the average man more credit than he probably deserves. And the woman probably think he got a higher body count than what he really got.
You out here being Steve Harvey. You telling all the secrets. So you done told us these
no
niggas
secrets.
Out here lying
they
on
really
their dick.
They hitting these bitches.
Ooh, y'all some
women lie. Women lie all the time, too.
Yeah, we lied to make our numbers go down.
Exactly.
Not to go up.
No bitches.
I've had women
around.
Lie and say we had sex that I ain't never talked to.
They lying on you, Jay?
Well, damn.
What?
She did did that to fuck some shit up.
Yeah. That's happened to me twice
yeah,
at
she
work.
She was trying to fuck and she just, up.
That happened to me twice
but
at
she
work.
Was being vengeful.
Yeah, that was,
yeah, that was.
Was
just being vengeful.
That was out of, yeah, she was
but
trying
what
to
I'm
fuck
just saying,
your, she
this
was trying to blow your spot
two
out.
Two different scenarios over my career at this one establishment where, like, I ain't never
man,
talked to you before.
Man, it was Comcast, but... so much pussy running through contests, man. That's like a that's factory all,
the
for
always
pussy.
The argument is like, well, men are celebrated by other men and they homies. Like, that's not a real a thing. That's not like us. No one's coming out and giving somebody an award. Oh, Jason, this is you have slept with 15 women this month. This is your prestigious award. Like, that's not, it's not a real thing. Like,
15 in a month is, that's
brutal. That's legendary. I see, think for that me, should that, be celebrated.
That's a bad thing for me, because I look at the bitches like I have. I look at your exes and I look at me and I be like, bitch, if you liked her, I'm not your type. Like, that's a turnoff.
Yeah, you are.
No.
Yeah, I don't like to see
that. So why is that the go-to argument was like, well, men are celebrated by other men, like by their friends and shit. Like, why is that the goal to...
And I think that's a man of a certain age. Once you get like... Niggas ain't talking, like, me and my friends, we really not talking about, like, who we fucking no more.
Nigga,
like,
you be in the group chat talking about all your weekends. What the fuck talking about?
You blowing this nigga's spot up like that?
What you doing that?
Oh, we not real on here. I'm sorry. You don't be doing that.
What would
you? Don't do that. He got the one friend.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Yeah, it's just one now.
It's that one friend.
I forgot.
He changed his way.
All I'm saying
is. He found Jesus. I'm sorry.
All I'm saying is that can't be it. It's just, you just can't
if
go
if it's the type of evening we gonna have, like, let's just put it out on the table. Like, let's take the gloves off real early if this is the type of evening we gonna have. Well, okay.
Jason, do you still got that Pepsi Cola, that Coca-Cola bottle I gave you with your name on
it? I believe so.
He lying. Send me a picture when you get home.
I look for it. It's in the box.
You just moved.
I did.
Just moved.
Oh, did you?
Anyway, let's move it on. Like,
I'm
so,
just thinking it's Christmas.
So stand, I mean, like that
did
whole.
Did you move alone or did you move?
Had a bitch.
I know, since you opened up that can.
I live with, know where it came from.
I live with a woman.
Some uncomfortable silence. Let's move on.
That's why he not body counting no more.
She's my friend. That's why he in here acting like Steve Harvey.
I'm not giving y'all. I'm not giving nobody no advice.
I stopped body counting like in my early 20s because it doesn't matter.
You body counted at the last
podcast. No. Nina body counted for me. Nina body counted on my behalf. I stopped body counting in like
and
my early 20s.
He texted us that Tuesday. Mm-hmm. Like, I think y'all was off.
Yeah.
I did this. And we like, no,
this
you
the best,
forgot
this
about
the best
this
way
that.
I can say it.
Because the body count doesn't matter. As long as I'm disease-free, like, that's all that all that counts.
But I say like
get
this.
Get rid of a lot of shit.
If you got...
And you'll never know about the shit that me and Penicillin done been through together. Like
that should
that.
Not be
aren't
your
you
goal,
ashamed
though.
To keep going to CVS and asking for penicillin?
First of all, I'm not
so
still
you,
going.
So you go
I'm
to CVS
going
for
to
your penicillin? Is that what you're telling?
Look, no, I mean, ain't no shame in my shit. If you can get rid of it, it didn't happen. It's a cold.
That's horrible.
It's a fucking cold.
Is does that include the pregnancies?
Ooh. Yes, if you
abortions?
Can get yes,
abortions?
Turn that baby into a soft serve. Turn that motherfucker to a smoothie. If you can get rid of the child, it does. Like I pay. If I didn't pay for all them abortions throughout my lifetime, I'd probably have about 11 kids.
God
so
damn.
I don't give no fuck about paying $350. It's better. $350 one time is better than $350 a month
years.
For 18 years. Yeah. Yes, I will kill that baby. Happily.
Say it like that.
I when do you want
to?
When do you want to go? Tomorrow?
I mean, I'm pro-life.
Yeah,
it's your own decision.
I think it's your body.
I'm sorry. Pro-choice. It's your own decision.
Yeah, I feel like it's your own decision too. But if you decide, this is how.
All right. So
hold
listen.
On.
I'm pro-abortion. More of these bitches should swallow. The one on your hip should have been on your lip. These hoes don't need to have babies. You got to have a license to do every motherfucking thing else except have a baby. These bitches need to stop having babies.
It's
they can't afford them, and I'm tired of paying for them.
It was a topic on the radio last week that was asking that question. Like, should the government be able to make women take birth control mm-hmm. who are on public assistance?
Absolutely.
And a lot of people were like, they should.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Like, why do you bitches keep having kids that you can't afford?
And they should drug test you if you're getting a bridge card.
That's
why should dope fiends be able to get a bridge card and then the motherfuckers want to sell it to me 60 cents on a dollar?
Because you're willing to buy 60 cents
on a dollar. 60 cents on a dollar.
Because I take the 40% discount on my groceries.
Right. The fuck you mean?
60 cents on a dollar?
Yeah.
I still get my bridge cards for half.
Let me tell you something. I had one. I was fucking with this one. Remember when we used to come? I was fucking with this one for like a year. I had his card every month. That motherfucker tried to sell it from under me. Talking about, well, somebody offered him 60 cents on a dollar. Do you want to get? I had the card. Bitch, I turned him into his motherfucking worker. Bitch, don't play with me.
Wow. No, you didn't. I can't believe that.
Oh, who? You don't know.
Turn them. We don't tell.
Who?
Because the hookup, the plug dried up. So
we don't tell.
Because I had that bridge car for, like, literally, he didn't get this bridge car. He didn't get the money on to the 9th. But on the 1st, I would go take him his money every month before you even got it. So then you come telling me, well, this month, before the 1st get here, well, this month, I want $60 instead of $50 or whatever, you know, whatever the.
So you snitched on him for $10?
Well, it's the overall increase of 10%. I mean, that's
10%. Yeah. We didn't have this agreement for a whole year.
Was it not $10?
It's the purpose.
Oh, well.
Yeah, we don't tell, though.
That motherfucker was cut off. Oh, but side note, y'all know it's a podcast called The Abortion Stories. Have y'all listened to that?
I'm not interested in it.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I mean, just like if. Look, David, whatever happens and you got.
I could tell some abortion stories.
Listen,
I could definitely tell.
Whatever happens.
You ever looked a bitch in the eye and told her that baby wasn't worthless to nobody but her? And meant it? That baby don't matter to nobody but you. Don't put another mistake out in this world. Now do the right thing.
I can't agree. Listen. Look, things happen. You make a mistake. Hey, things happen. But if you continue to do this, that's you. You making a conscious decision to do that. And that does impact more than just you. Like, and I think the man should have a say whether he keeping the baby or not. It's two people to make it. It should be more than one person to take it away. So if I say I want to have this child, you say you don't want, or if I say no, like I think it should, if it takes two people to make the baby, I think it should be a joint decision to rather keep it.
No, you got some niggas. As soon as you can carry it for 40 weeks, then you can make the decision.
I was about to say, you got some niggas out here that's breeders. Like, that's what them niggas do. Like, they fuck bitches too nut in them.
Well,
and
it takes two people
babies
to have sex. So if it ain't just the man of you, if
just
you
because I agreed
on
to have sex with you, don't mean I agreed to get skeeted in. I agreed to have sex.
But you an
my
adult.
My son is adults a keep a bitch baby.
Like, we know, like, 1 + 1 = 2.
But
if a nigga beat
pull her out, like, pull the fuck out. Like, don't
my son
agree
is
to
here
it before.
Wait a minute.
My
son is a keep a bitch baby. He literally took the condom off.
Okay.
I swear for everything I love, Bryce will be 20 years old on March, in March 10th. He took the condom off. I was not trying to have a baby. I was actually on the pill and got pregnant. That's the only reason why he ain't hearing his sisters and brothers. I mean, he hearing his sisters and brothers ain't. Because Lord knows, on the pill and the condom and you pulled out, he was supposed to be here.
Well, he didn't really pull out.
Listen,
I'm just saying, this
I know he took the condom off because
point,
I know
you gotta
I gave
take
it
some
to
responsibility for yourself. Just make better decisions. Things happen. You know what I'm saying? But if it continue to happen, like when you on your 9th and 10th one, like Jesus, this fucking strap up.
9th and 10th? When you on your 2nd.
Like shit.
The Bible said happen. Be fruitful and multiply. 1 × 1 = 1. Anything ever after 2, one girl and one boy is merely repetitious. What the fuck you gonna have next? A kangaroo?
All right, man. We're moving on to the next topic. Okay.
Turn that baby to a soft serve. And just,
a
yeah
smoothie.
Turn that baby to a smoothie.
All right. So there was a question that came across my Facebook, and I thought it was pretty interesting. And it was a question to men. He said, fellas, you're about to marry your fiance, and she wants to keep her father's name and put yours at the end.
No, bitch.
Is that a serious problem, and what do you do with that?
Yes, it's a motherfucking problem.
Yeah, this is a man question.
It gotta be. I'm still the same motherfucker I was before I got married. I am me. I did not take my husband's last name, and I did not hyphenate my name. I was supposed to after 5 years, and I just don't want to.
So like, you're not changing your name ever?
No, I'm me.
So you didn't even Social Security change it up, Nina Patrick?
Why is that?
Because one, when we first got married, I was really on some, I don't know, because my dad has been married a million times and my mom has been married a million times too.
So
I was like, I don't know, because divorce is running high in my family.
But his parents been together forever.
That's not some shit that run high in your family. That's not like the common. Like,
he's not registered.
Yeah, everybody.
It's not diabetes.
Yeah, everybody.
I mean, it's hereditary if you weren't presented with a good example and
exactly
you learned from
positive relationship role models.
Yeah, everybody in my family has been divorced at least twice.
I'm not getting married if I think I'm getting divorced.
I agree.
Like, that's some forever shit. It's like the divorce.
You plan on it being forever, but until you win that shit and going through the back and forth, like, I thought I'd be married forever.
Okay.
And until I started, like,
cool
getting into that shit,
but
like,
that's cool because you went in saying I'm being married forever. But if I'm going in thinking this can possibly leave 75% say yes, 25% say no, I'm not doing it.
Me and my husband have a divorce plan. That is shit that needs to be talked about. Like, you don't know what happened.
But that divorce plan to go out the window when y'all get in the court.
So y'all niggas not even married. Y'all just in a super relationship. Y'all super boyfriend and girlfriends.
Yeah, we're like...
It's a business. A marriage is a business contract. And people really need to think more about it.
Is the concept of marriage outdated, that whole podcast episode. But, like, for those who...
It's a business arrangement.
It's literally a straight up a business deal between yourself, this woman, and the government.
But it's a business deal you can get out of pretty easily, though.
Yeah, it is. Yeah,
but you shouldn't. And that's the thing. That's what's really more important. Honoring the commitment.
It's a business deal.
Absolutely. But I committed. If this is your business, mm-hmm. I'm going to do whatever I got to do until the motherfucking walls fall down. I'm going to be in here and I'm going to make it work until it's over.
So thinking of it as a business decision, right? When two companies come together and decide to work together, mm-hmm. there's a mutual benefit. Mm-hmm. So if I come in with a company and I'm responsible for 90% of all the cost and mm-hmm. only get 10% of the profits, why should I go into business with this particular person?
I can see
and that's that whole role thing that we were doing. Like, so since it's a business relationship, what is it? What do I get out of this?
Like,
it's just 90-10.
But it's not 90-10. It's not 90-10 because you can't quantify what the 10% does.
I'm not geeked up to take no bullshit ass last name like Johnson Smith and
Brown. Hold on, nigga. My last name Johnson. Hold on, nigga.
I'm just saying, if your last name not Roc-a-fella or something like that, I don't see no point in fucking changing it. Just continue to be you. People are just too into, like, the little small shit. Move on from that. You don't have to have that nigga's last name for it to be real.
You don't got to get married for it to be real.
No, you don't. But
you
I just
want my health insurance.
Like, I can't even go on his health insurance.
Because you want to change your last name?
No, because I got to be unemployed. My job offers me insurance, so I can't go on his insurance.
That's fucked up.
Damn.
He need another company.
I thought whoever had the best one, they just go with that.
DTE, with their employees, the spouse or mate has to be unemployed.
Oh, okay.
When I was married, I was hyphenated.
I think you should take my last name. If you want all this commitment because we want to do this, I think you should take my last name.
And your last name whack.
Sorry. It's the number two last name in the country.
For niggas.
you can't enact logic with bullshit. So if this whole thing where you wanna go through the whole little tradition shit and everything like that, and you taking my last name, and the matter of fact, you wouldn't even have your last name if your mama thought like you thought. Like, the reason that you got your father's name is because your mama went with the program. And if you want to keep your father's name, you need to do like your mama did and take her husband.
No, my kids still gonna have my husband's last name. They don't have nothing to do with my kids.
So why are you trying to be the rebellious one? Like, what you saving out? Like, you don't think it's forever? Or, like, if your kids, you don't give your kids that last name, you okay with your kids even having
if
that last
name? If we in this house, we all got my last name.
Even if me and him wasn't together and let's just say I just ended up being a baby mama, my kids are still going to take his last name. Because if anything is to happen to that nigga, it's hard to fight for Social Security when them kids don't have that last name.
So this is strictly financial. It ain't got shit to do with nothing else.
We just told you it's a business deal. Them kids can't get no Social Security.
I'm glad that y'all keep rolling with this.
Well, I changed my name, and I was very happy to change my name.
I'm glad to hear you say that. Why were you happy to change your name?
I don't know. It just felt, at the time, it felt like the right thing to do. It felt enlightening. Like, I felt like it was, you know, you leave from your father and your mother, and you go and you be a
cleave
part of
onto your husband.
Yeah.
And y'all about to start, this is a new family. You about to start.
Exactly.
You about to start your own family reunion.
And my own legacy with my husband and our family that we have together. So that was my thought.
I hyphenated because I had a child before I went into the marriage. Although he has his father's name, his last name legally is hyphenated as well. So he has Wade Hicks. My last name, personally, I have my mother's husband's last name because she was legally married. And when I was born, whether you were legally, even though they were not together, he is not my father. His name is on my birth certificate. So I had daddy. this nigga last name, and he not even my daddy. He my brother daddy. So actually, the name don't mean anything to me. I just like the way it sound.
Okay.
So I really don't care about being a Wade.
So this is very interesting to me because you guys have said this on a couple different, it's financial and all the other stuff. We explain what the man is and blah, blah, blah. Do we agree that are we in the same Are men and women equal?
I feel like he's trying to back us into it.
Yeah, I think
we're just using the fact that we're going to
say yes.
All right.
In my life, men and women are equal.
All right.
A man would probably disagree with that, but I'm going to say that we are.
Equal okay. As far as what?
I mean, we create. I think human beings should be like on an equal playing field. You know what I'm saying? I think everybody's supposed to be equal. So this is the question I have, right? So we are explaining that the man is supposed to take care of everything. And then, like you said, like there is no monetary value that you can put on taking care of the house, taking care of the kids and everything like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in a situation where, say, Michael Jordan,
mm-hmm.
he divorces from his wife. She takes half of the money, like mm-hmm. $500 million. However, it was a substantial mm-hmm. amount of money. Mm-hmm. And we, from the outside looking in, like, man, this man ain't dribbling. No, he dribbled the basketball. He sold the shoes and everything. I was like, but wait, she took care of the kids. She took care of the house. You can't put a price on that. Mm-hmm. Boom. She deserved half. Right. Mm-hmm. Cool. So let's take a situation where the man stays home, does all that, and the woman works.
Mm-hmm.
We looked at, that's looked at as the man is taking advantage of her, or he's less than a man, or that's quote unquote wrong. But we just started with the Michael Jordan situation, just proved that whatever she does at home is worth half of the whole empire. But when you flip the script, it's like, uh-oh.
Because it was cool when Juanita did it to Mike, but when Kendu did it to Mary, it's like niggas look down on that shit.
Like,
you're right.
I want to know, because like, how you feel about
far.
That.
Kendu yeah, went too far. He got her Grammys and shit. Give her back her damn Grammys. You ain't sung not one song.
But I managed your career while you sang.
But you got paid to be her manager, see, but okay, he wanted yeah. too much shit. Like, he right. wanted his mama, his kids taken care of,
he wanted to maintain the same type of lifestyle he had become accustomed
that
to.
Was even more.
Yeah, but that don't have nothing to do with some other bitch's kids and your mama in them.
So
now,
what I'm saying is,
you,
from Tiger Woods' wife to all these different, from Paul McCartney's wife, the new, like, if what they did at home, y'all make a case for, he took care of the kids, he took care of the house. If you making case and say, for in this particular situation, that's worth half, when you flip that shit around, it should be viewed the same way, right?
So I don't believe that that's the case. So for me, I look at earning potential. Like when we talked about the Mary and Kendu situation, I'm looking at what would his earning potential had have been had he continued upon his path and not helped her with hers? What would that earning potential would have been?
That's you.
Okay, you were a business manager. Okay, so you know, account manager, whatever. So you made $250,000 a year, $300,000, whatever. Say you were good. You made $300,000 a year. Okay, now look at any severance package, pension. You would not have gotten that. You would not have ever been at that $2 million. I think
Explain to me.
Did the math. $2 billion a year. Yeah. You would not have ever earned that, no matter what.
I got
even
what
if you never
saying.
Married me.
I understand what you're saying, but that's not what they used to calculate that shit. What did Juanita Jordan? How? What was her earning potential?
I'm not necessarily saying that that's correct. My point is, I don't feel that it should be 50 cents.
But what you're failing to understand, the reason why
for
Juanita
male or female,
got that money
she was
is
with that nigga from the beginning.
That
from jump. Let's start there.
Them KIDSs. Those get yep. you the change. If there's no
key, it was grown already though.
No, all okay. of them wasn't grown.
Nah, she put her she own life on the back burner.
Back burner, nigga. I'm the richest you, nigga out here.
And
you
live back burner. She put
and
her
and
life to help
burner?
Raise his family.
But what type of good ass life
family.
You do? What kind of good ass life you live in? Help having my kids,
like
and raising my family.
But that doesn't.
But
so
that
every,
you never
wait,
have
wait,
to
wait,
work.
Every woman doesn't want to
be a mother.
I don't enjoy being a mother. Every woman does not want to be a mother. I don't like the responsibility of being a mother. I absolutely love my son, but that's why I only got one. I don't like that I'm responsible for the lifestyle. And no matter, even us sitting around this table now, we're still talking about, grown as hell, talking about how our parents raised us. I don't like being responsible for somebody else. So every woman doesn't want to be a mother. Maybe she wanted to go off. Maybe she would have been a billionaire on her own.
I doubt
had
it.
She not been taking care of his kids. Maybe she would have been off and her earning potential would have been, she would have been a clothing designer or ain't no telling what she could have done.
And she's a mother for
mother.
Life.
He's
and he's
father
not a father
for life.
For life.
That nigga went on and had babies with some other little girl half his age.
He got more so now, fathers.
So he's so I'm still the father. I'm a father to all these kids.
So basically, I just want to point out how we just explained that being the stay-at-home mom.
Okay,
who take care
I
of the
think
kids,
Juanita deserved half, but I'm sorry. Kendu did not deserve half, if that's where your question is going.
Because those aren't Mary's kids. I'm not paying for your other
Mary
kids.
Already had her whole lifestyle. Like, she was an established artist by the time she married him. Her mm-hmm. career was already thriving and very successful. She had Grammys. That nigga came along later.
That's how you
jumped. He jumped on her, and she put him in that position to be her manager. And then when it didn't work out, why should he get all that? They weren't even married that
long. This ain't got nothing to do with
him being
the manager.
They were married 10 plus years.
This ain't got nothing to do with the manager. This is about marriage.
Years.
So once you become
making it about specific situations and specific marriages. Let's look at the criteria and the things that went into it. He wasn't there from the jump. Had he been around when Mary was first getting on?
She was shooting in the gym.
So Paul McCartney was married to his wife for 30 years. She passed away. He found a new girl. They was married 18 months. They get divorced. She got fucking half his money.
I don't think she should not have.
Well, that's the law.
He shouldn't have married her in California.
In California, when you file in California, 50%. Half, no matter what.
Well, then he should have took up with that.
He shouldn't have married her in California.
And guess what? Mary J. Blige stayed, too.
Because guess what? My husband from New York, and they got that shit. I almost would have owed him alimony.
So, I got a question, right? So, say the wife, she's a doctor somewhere. Matter of fact, both of them was a doctor somewhere, right? Mm-hmm. She makes, say, $500,000 a year. And via their lifestyle, it is literally there is no reason that both of us need to get up and go to work in the morning. Like, no matter what. One of our incomes is going to take care of this shit, and she wants to be a doctor. Is he any less of a man for not working?
Because
it's literally no reason for me. Like, at this point, I'm going to get up and go to work just because I don't want to look funny. Because, like, we literally have enough money to raise to keep our lifestyle and everything. Like, there's no so for an example, if I made enough money to support 2 and 3 different households, like, I wouldn't have my wife or my girlfriend or anything going to work. Like, I'm not going to see you to work just because. Like, why?
Because you could find other things to do.
Yeah.
Because then you need to be working for our business. You need to be doing something philanthropic, or you need to be doing something, a foundation
like
for
you'll
our
get
children
busy.
Or something. You got to do
something.
You're
not going to sit
else.
At home and be bored.
You just about to sit on your ass.
But you need a plan.
So that's
B.
Like, so you think, so
why can't I just go to the gym and go shopping? Because I'm sure Juanita did a lot of that shit.
But she also ran his foundations and his camps and his...
Man, the Bulls ran the foundation.
Like, your name may have been on paperwork for tax purposes, but I don't know if
that's enough. Well, that's enough the reason why she should get the
money.
What
I'm saying is,
my name.
If you marry and one of y'all make enough money that, like, literally there's no reason for both of us to be getting up working 40 hours a week or whatever, is he less of a man for not working?
No, but he has to do something.
Yeah,
he has to bring some value into this household. So, even if it's not necessarily dollars, he has to bring some value into this household.
So to say that means that outside of working, he had no value besides working?
No.
Because to say that, like, well, you got to do this now, like, that's
either,
to say.
It's either one or the other or both. Like, if we're both working, like we were talking about earlier, okay, who's going to get called if the kid gets sick? Well, then I expect you to be at every PTA meeting. I expect you to, you know what I mean? Like, you have to be bringing some value. You have to lighten
my
burden.
Your penis got
to
be healthy.
Y'all see what you see what's going to happen is whoever make the money is calling the shots, and this is what you should do. I make the money, yo ass going to the PTA. I make the money, you doing this. Yeah. So on the reverse side, when the man make the money and say, hey, since I make the money, you going to do this, they looked at as a chauvinist.
No, you're not.
I don't think so.
No, I think that you're reaching
what's that
out.
Face?
There's certain things that I'm not going to do. I'm not pumping gas. I'm not rolling out the trash. I'm not mopping the floors. There's certain things things I do.
Mopping the floors doesn't fall under cleaning the house?
Not for a woman.
Well, I have a maid, so.
I'm just saying.
Like, literally, what is the world of you? Like, if really, because, like, it'd probably be cheaper.
And I bet who paying for the maid? Me.
Like, it'd be cheaper to just have somebody on the side to have sex with. Like, I mean, if I'm going to pay for everything.
Oh, it's definitely cheaper to get a bitch on the side than me. I'm expensive.
So we're going to move on to our next topic.
I mean, that was just point blank shit.
I make no apologies. I gave away all the free pussy I was going to give out in my 20s.
What do you feel about women proposing?
No.
Man, them bitches is whack. Y'all need to cut that motherfucking shit out. Stop that. You looking ridiculous out here on your knees. Proposing to these niggas, that nigga will be with you when he ready. And if he ain't never ready, then that ain't the nigga for you. Stop that shit.
Why can't we just be together without me ever having to propose? Like,
let's. There's some people okay with that, and because
Jimmy is doing that shit every week with Chrissy, and I love.
But he did propose.
Yeah, he did.
He keep pushing that wedding back. It's never gonna happen, and there's nothing wrong with that. She lives a comfortable life. I'm sure she works little to nothing. Like, just let that nigga be and let him cheat in peace.
She put up with way too much. I think that bitchifies men, and that's why men are so.
Explain that. I don't know what that means.
It's blurring the lines of masculinity. When a woman is proposing on her knees, proposing for a man and begging a man to be a part of her life, that ain't of God.
The Bible you think says, that's begging?
He that findeth a wife findeth the good thing. He that findeth, not she that findeth. A woman is just not supposed to force the man to be ready. Like Nina said, you're just not supposed to force
him. I mean, to ask a question. So if a woman literally says, hey, I want to get married, you think that's forcing him to get married?
No, I mean, if she suggests it, no, you can bring it up and let's have a conversation. But absolutely. I'm not about to call all right now, your homeboys sound over like to
y'all,
the house.
It sounds like y'all playing semantics. Because if the woman can suggest it and lead you and nudge you to it, if she just asks, it's the same shit.
No man ever decided to propose to a woman by themselves. They were led. You knew my intention. That's just like I ain't never asked a nigga for money, but I always get it. You don't have to ask. It's you let your requests be known. I don't have to ask you for money.
So what if I don't pick up on your request?
Well, then you stupid and we shouldn't be together.
Or he just didn't pick up on the request.
Yeah, because I'm not asking.
If we've been together long enough that we're even talking about marriage, then you understand what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying. We've had conversations. At this age, you over 30, you know whether or not you want to be with a bitch after 12 months, period. You're not about to keep
renting the pussy. Who that sound like? That sound like Steve.
Well, he said 90 days. That nigga was fooling.
You're not about to keep renting the pussy. I'm sorry. Like, you're not about to keep putting mileage on my pussy so I can be like, I was with this
you
nigga
got to,
5 years.
You got to be
I was
worth
with this
more
nigga 6 years,
your...
and I still ain't got no ring.
Getting a hot bath. With
you
that
always bridesmaid, never the bride.
So you care more about. No,
you getting a hot bath with that apple cider vinegar? Snap right back. You won't even.
It's not even. I'm
you
not
won't even. The mileage goes away.
The sex. I'm saying the time.
A woman asked me to marry her before.
I invested these amount
and where
of
she
years
at now?
Into your. He ain't with her. He ain't married.
You got rid of her because the bitch was weak. That's weak bitch shit.
He ain't married her.
But it's okay for you to hint at it, but not directly ask. It's the same
it's
shit.
Not, no, it's not.
It's semantics.
No, it's not. Because what I'm about to do is fill you out. Because if you tell me some shit like, oh, I'm not feeling marriage, I don't want to get married, then I need to move on from you. So really what I'm doing is trying to see, is this a possibility?
So if you
but I got to pay all the bills
and
you change your last
so
name.
So if you and your lady in the mall and she said, hey, let's go over there and go ring shopping. You might as well be asking me. You literally are telling me I'm ready to. Like, you are literally saying, come buy me a ring.
She helped you pick out your ring?
Right, like,
she
literally.
She helped you pick out your ring?
If you suggest.
Try this one on.
So I know, I understand y'all gonna say it's not the same, mm-hmm. but to me, you basically gave me the, like, hey, I wanna get married. That's what you just told me when you said, mm-hmm. let's go ring shopping. So you wanna play some matches with you, literally getting on your knee, the whole, the ceremonial shit like that. That's cool. But once you say, hey, let's go ring shopping, you literally just ask if we can get married.
Jay, I'm trying to save you a couple dollars because I don't want you getting no old granddaddy ass ring that
that's
I don't
cool,
like.
But
I'm
you
not
do
going
realize,
for no motherfucking cluster or no diamond dust or no sprinkles. So
it's still a diamond. It's still a diamond.
I'm tell you it ain't.
But you wouldn't
it's
be doing
glitter.
That. But you wouldn't be
I'm
doing that.
I'm gonna tell you what I want so that you make the right decision when you decide.
But you wouldn't be doing that if you didn't want to get married to that man. You wouldn't be going ring shopping for you if you didn't want to get married to that
I
man.
Carry picture. I carry a picture of my ring.
Let me say, it is necessary that people have that conversation. It's a lot of people that don't want to get married.
Mm-hmm.
So girls are going to like try to fill it out because if you want some shit like that, then this isn't for me. I need to move on and find somebody else. So it's not really like I'm throwing hints that this is what I want. I'm trying to fill you out to see if this is what's going to happen.
Because yeah. you want to get married to him.
No, I want to get married. Whether it's with him or somebody else, that's my
so
end
just,
goal.
So you just want to see if I'm down with the idea of getting married.
And
so.
She may see you as a potential spouse, well, or else she wouldn't be even dating you.
Yeah.
So why can't y'all just be together and not be married? Like, why do you just can't be happy?
Okay, I got a good story. My sister, my stepsister's boyfriend's parents, they've been married 30 years now. When I met them, they had been together 20 years. Out of the 20 years that they've been together total, they were married for 5 years. They were together. They got married. When they got married, shit went to hell. They said they was fighting. They wasn't getting along. They got a divorce. but they never left each other. They separated bedrooms while they was going through the divorce. The mama was supposed to move. She just never did. They ended up being cool again. They ended up getting back together, and they've been together ever since. They're just not legally married.
You know how retarded that shit is?
No, it's like Yandy and Mandisi's.
No, when I say retarded, it's like you let a concept, a outside control concept, control you. It's the same. Y'all the same two people. Whether y'all, because y'all put a piece
so
of metal.
So are you saying that you agree or disagree with that situation, whereas they were together, got
I'm perfectly
divorced.
Fine with them so you would just be okay. Being together.
Okay.
What I'm saying is it's unfortunate that y'all loved and liked each other before. You signed a little piece of paper and you put a piece of metal on your finger and now y'all start acting different. Like
right.
the companionship, the love, the respect, the day-to-day, that should have always been there. Just me putting the ring on and signing a piece of paper should not have changed anything.
The level
but
of
we
commitment.
Let that. Cause like well, you said, you looking for
does.
A marriage. You was like, I don't know. I'm looking to get married. You said, I don't know if you, this might be the potential person, but I'm looking to get married. That's what we had just said. But it should be, I'm looking for somebody who I want to connect with versus I'm looking for a marriage. I'm looking for a ring. I'm looking for my wedding. It should be, I want a companionship with this person.
I think it depends on the age that y'all get together because people change. If it's a situation where y'all got together in y'all early 20s and niggas then hit 30, y'all might not be the same people y'all was at 22. People change.
Absolutely.
So who you evolve into, that I might not be feeling that person. You know what I'm saying? So that you can't say that.
But they might not be feeling you. I think that people, as we grow, I mean, our
yeah, that's what I'm saying.
We've been friends damn near 10 years. Our friendship is not the same as it was when we first
yeah.
met. You know what I'm saying? Our friendship has
yeah,
evolved.
Yeah.
So
things
I think
change.
That... Absolutely. I think that you grow in and out of love with people. The
I agree with you
the
on.
More
Absolutely.
Important part is the commitment. Do you honor your commitment? Regardless, am I going to love, do I love who you are in your core? Regardless of who, if you cut your hair long or short, if you decide to get dreadlocks or bald.
What if
head?
I decide to get fat? As hell.
As a nigga?
Yeah. Okay. So I don't want no fat ass wife. Is
a woman,
wrong
a woman shouldn't let herself go. A woman shouldn't let herself go ever. I'm sorry. Jay, you got it. I'm chauvinistic on that. Women should not be fat
I agree
and
with that shit.
Overweight and not take care of themselves. That just is not ladylike. I'm sorry. And if I was ever obese, I would go to the best plastic surgeon I could find. I'd pop pussy, whatever I had to do to get that $10,000 to get that shit.
With your money or my money?
Whatever. Well, if you love me enough and I got fat, I would hope that you would help me.
Wait. So okay. You're going to be popping fat pussy? Is that what you just said?
I would pop whatever the head pussy.
Ain't nobody fit
whatever.
For fat pussy.
Whatever it takes, I would not be fat. Our time. Period.
Oh, shit.
Yo, all right. I know fat bitches is tricking. Swear to God. Right now.
And you
days.
Paying for it?
No. Hey, no.
You fucking fat bitches.
It's
$40.
It's somebody for it. It's somebody for everybody, apparently.
It is.
All right, here go the next question. Ladies. If you are celibate, when is the time that you tell the guy that you're dating?
First date.
Yeah,
I think that
date.
Shit
Clear
needs to be.
Clear that up early.
Yeah, that's why bitches is out here getting raped.
Jesus
because,
Christ.
No, I'm serious. You can't be out here.
You make some. That's a giant fucking jump.
No,
like, she ain't tell me on the first date.
I understand what she's saying.
No, that is some serious shit. Like, men are, I mean, we know they're very horny. It's some niggas out here that like the fuck. You can't be with these niggas. And think you not gonna get fucked. So if you not fucking, you need to say something so he can move on.
So
or he can
the
decide.
Very first date
yes,
or
the first
yeah, the
no,
first
I think
date.
You should tell me before we go on the
first
date.
Conversation. Before the
yeah,
first date.
I think
yeah.
That shit like, hey, what you doing?
One.
When you texting, nothing, what you about, shit, celibacy.
Right.
Yeah. I'm not fucking.
You know, I'm
that
working
on
me.
That should actually be your Instagram
Absolutely.
Name. Like, I'm not fucking. You
okay,
know,
that's
26.
Fair.
I think she's right. She right on that.
I have a 90-day rule, and I tell you from the first.
We about to get. We about to get
the.
So the 90-day rule.
Months, but I almost fucked around and got quit though.
90-day rule.
Because I was supposed to go 6 months.
Ooh.
So you 90-day rule.
So I'm supposed to take you out, be nice to you, buy you shit, all of this for 6 months.
That nigga was sleeping in the. He was spending the night at my house, but I would make him sleep.
What we
on
said
top
on
the
last? We said on the last episode, like
in the bed with his hands crossed.
If it costs me money every time I see you, like this
it's
is not a relationship worth me
seeing.
It's not a relationship. Like you know, every time I see you, if it costs me money, like we got to reexamine this.
Unless
not that you don't want to spend money, like, but literally every time I talk to you or see you, I have to spend money. That's a little weird, right?
Unless you and her live together, every time you see her, you should be spending money.
Why is that?
What do you mean?
Why should it cost?
That's what I mean. Like, why every time because I see you, I should pay you more?
What courting is. It's spending money.
Courting is spending time.
And money is in the Bible.
It is.
So now we believe the Bible.
It says, he who spend the most money shall get a wife.
The most pussy.
He shall get the most.
It just seemed like money is always the recurring theme here.
I shouldn't have to come out of money every time I see you.
Let's stop pretending that that the oldest profession is not selling pussy. Let's stop pretending that the oldest form of currency is not sex. Period. Your mama sold pussy to your daddy. She probably still
do. So if I can buy it for cheaper, don't act like it's a premium on yours.
Oh no. Because there are Bentleys and there are Escorts. There's different. They all cars. They gonna get you from A to B.
Yeah.
Every woman think they got the best pussy. Every woman think they got the best head.
Listen, that's I just ain't tried it, them that, all. That's just, I don't know.
And
I
a man gonna tell you that you got the best. Like, that's just how it goes.
You said what?
And a man gonna tell you what you want to hear. Just how you would tell
that's
a nigga what you want to hear.
That is a
well, if he care about you, if he care about you, if I don't care about you, I tell you that shit.
Nigga, my husband told me one night my pussy was whack. I mean, I'll go ahead.
Shout out to your husband.
I mean, I was...
Shout out my nigga Dwayne.
So he need to...
Call it out. Call it out, Wayne.
He need to adjust those percentages and shit. That's what he turned him...
And he's
little,
still paying all the bills. 60-40. Now, if whack pussy 50. Can get all the bill paid, what you think good pussy gonna get?
I mean, he wasn't saying, like, it's whack on a permanent basis. He was just saying that night.
Like, damn, babe, you was lazy. Yeah.
Yeah, it was about an E+.
You just lay there?
I wasn't feeling like it at all, dog. Okay. Like, take your drunk ass on somewhere and go lay down, dog. Oh,
I can't stand drunk dick.
Yeah, go get... Well, I don't mind drunk... Drunk dick is the best dick if you're drunk, too. But drunk
not
and...
Not when I'm not drunk. No.
Yeah, drunk and sober, I can't do that. Mm-hmm. You better go in the corner and get your shit like a man in my juvenile voice. Go on over there.
No, not my wife is laying in bed.
Nigga, what? Just because you're married doesn't mean you get pussy on demand. And that's another y'all
why,
got stuck.
Why not?
So, nigga, because I might be tired. So I mean, if I don't
as
work,
a woman,
I'm not, then okay.
Now, so I'm not gonna, question. Hold on. Let me get this off. I'm not going to say I'm going to be beating on you. Like, it's, I'm just going to be on your back every night. I get it. You might be tired. But like, 4 nights out the week, you need to toot that shit up in the air and just be ready to fuck.
I know some motherfuckers.
At least 4 nights out the week, you need to put that pussy in the air.
I know some motherfuckers ain't getting 4 times a month.
What?
So as a woman,
and I don't care nothing about that period coming.
So as a woman,
this nigga was listen, what is
so
on?
As a woman, and you ask your man for
run
sex,
red lights,
and he say no. How is that conversation?
You mad? If a nigga denies you to have sex, you mad?
Oh, you been fucking some other bitch? Because I don't.
So as a man, when he want to have sex with his wife, and she say no, shouldn't he be mad too?
No, he just needs to go somewhere and sit down.
Like, that's, I mean, like, because when
I'm going to disagree. I'm just going to do it. Damn.
Thank you, Tina, for being reasonable.
And sometimes I just overdo it. Like, if I know that I don't want to do it, like, by the end of the week, I'm going to be tired as hell. I'm going to wear your ass out at least for the whole night, maybe 2 days in a row, so that I can get 5 days off. And it works.
I'll take that.
Okay.
Now, I agree with that.
But 4 days straight, that's too much. But I'm going to act like I'm the horniest bitch you know. Like, oh, you going to do it again and again. And he going to
I go ahead and, you know, get it out the way. Let's just move on here. I go ahead and, you know, and put in all the work so we can just move on. But, like, back to the question. Like, yeah, if you sell a man, you need to tell a nigga up front.
First date? Or maybe, like, second date?
No, you need to tell that nigga in that text conversation.
Before you spend money on me, I need you to know.
No, that I'm not fucking.
That you're, before we go out to Jay Alexander, before you spend this $100, I'm going to need you to know that there is no pussy coming at the end of this night.
Unless you take me to Applebee's. And then
I could take myself to Jay Alexander and you not get no pussy. I literally.
I like Applebee's. I tweeted that shit. I'm like, listen, I know motherfuckers be like, Applebee's is not a date. Well, fuck it. I like Applebee's. I'm about to go sit at the bar. Do you want to come too? Or I'm going to go by myself. Okay?
But Applebee's doesn't get you pussy. Like,
nigga, tacos at the crib will get you some pussy.
No.
Like, so.
Wait, you was just the one a little earlier that said that niggas ain't getting pussy like that. Now you saying that the Taco Bell
I said every average nigga can't go get pussy on demand. And that's the, like, every nigga that walk, you just go find random nigga in the mall and say, hey, go get some pussy right now. It's not going to happen.
He might not have no game.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Everybody not.
That's what it is. That's a difference.
Yeah, because everybody don't. Everybody not equal. Because if everybody had the same game, then that game is regular. And then you had to have some extra shit. It's tiers to everything.
All
it's
you levels to this shit. It's
levels.
We all got
they
what?
They all think they got game. They are. That's their game. And oh, thank you. And then a lot of niggas' game is the fact that they don't have no game. It's a lot of niggas getting pussy off that shit. Yeah. Oh, baby, I don't really know what to do with you, you know.
You gave some niggas some pussy up that line. That's what it was. Shit. Like, hey,
fuck. Next thing you know, you got niggas peeing in the bed.
That's just like a. Here we go.
That was
here
that.
We go. That's it. Oh, I ran have another gag. I actually went to his establishment and ran into him not too long ago. Long story. I have to tell it after the podcast. But just to give y'all an update on that situation, I asked that nigga what was going on, and that nigga told me that he's still peeing in the bed.
Jesus fucking Christ.
So we're going to pray for him.
No, we not. All no, right. We're not. Tax season coming up. Just buy your new matches, bro. Keep on doing it. All clearly, right. You ain't figured out how to stop it now.
So I was got like, a question. You still suffering from that problem? He was like, every now and again, you know.
Jesus Christ.
Nigga, you need to go to the doctor. I did. They said
that
I
might
got
be prostate cancer.
That nigga
some
told
shit.
Me the doctor sounds- said that he got a really, 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 really bad. Bladder. No, a really, 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 really weak bladder. Nigga, ain't no doctor gave you that many motherfucking really.
You need, well, you need to do him like motherfucking a motherfucking 2 year old. Stop drinking at the 7, bitch.
Yeah. No, and how we got yeah. on.
And sorry, listen. Another question. Before we get off, before we get to PP dude again and shit. I don't want no problems and shit, all right?
Oh, me.
God damn it. I got two questions in regards to dates. Y'all know we did an episode. We talked about $200 dates and shit. Like, what is the cost of a, for what you call a date? Because you kind of alluded to Applebee's not being a date. That's like a Twitter shit that never goes.
And you kind of mentioned like Jay Alexander wouldn't. Mm-hmm. It was just... We just going out to eat.
It's yeah, I like mean, we just about to go out to eat and grab mm-hmm. some eat and have some conversation. That's not a date. Like, if you trying to date me, I feel a date. Like,
so we talking niggas we not with. We just talking some random, arbitrary, I met a nigga on the street.
So, like, Will wanted to take you out.
Okay.
And what would Will have to do to make it a date in your eyes?
I mean, we going to have to go on a date. Like, we going to go eat. But I guess I don't have... I don't know, maybe I'm not your average woman, but I don't look at it as you got to spend a certain amount of money in order for it to be considered a date.
Tina, you are changing my opinion of you you're every not, time you open your mouth.
She's the same one on this.
Because me and my husband, we done went to McDonald's. Like, we'll go in there and sit in McDonald's to eat. And I mean, the average woman probably would be like, nigga, you ain't taking me no big... We have fun. Like, to me, sometimes you gonna spend the night a lot and you gonna ball out. And sometimes you just, we might go to Taco Bell at the mall. Like, I just right. feel like it
oh,
just
no,
can't
I'm not
be.
Saying but you got his last name. He's paid for that privilege. We're talking
but
about
even when we were dating.
We're talking about courtship. Like, from the beginning, you need to be impressing me. That's just like
I
right
used to
now.
Go through the drive-thru at McDonald's. He would want a number 10 well, fish filet. And so we would,
listen,
we would
that's
both
the
smash
same way as
filet.
When you first met him, when he was coming over, you was still putting on certain stuff, putting your makeup on a certain way, put dress in a certain way. But as the time went on, you don't have to do those things I as say, much anymore.
You just said a woman it's don't have to let herself shouldn't let herself go. Ain't never
let
you
yourself
go
don't mean primping like for a date. For me, a date is making plans and reservations. Not necessarily we just flying by the seat of our pants, because we do that. Shit, we called each other last week, a couple weeks ago with starters. That we date each other if that's the case as friends. I'm
no,
talking about plans
a
and reservations.
A date is me going me and you going somewhere to talk and hopes of building a relationship and moving forward.
That's
that don't
saying.
Got nothing to
making
do with
plans.
I'm saying, but that don't got nothing to do if it costs a certain amount of money or if we right. had to set a reservation. It literally could
no,
be the start.
I don't
listen,
care about the dollar amount.
I don't eat lobster. I don't eat seafood. But if I wanted to go to Starters and get some lobster and I want you to come with me, hey, would you want to go to Starters with me? We gonna sit there. We gonna eat. We gonna
Starters
kick it. We gonna have
is
a,
not a date.
That's not a date.
Oh, come on, y'all. If you eating and
let
you're
me
getting
explain,
fed.
Let
if you're
me,
eating
let me
free,
explain.
I think it's
wait,
a date.
Exactly. No, let me explain
what is
what
a
I'm
date?
Saying.
What is a date?
Let me explain. This is how my...
See, that's these bitches with these false expectations.
No, this
like,
is how...
enjoy. Just
no,
enjoy
it's only
a
false
moment.
If it's not happening.
But
it's
to me, you just...
Every
you can't,
single solitary
what's a date,
day.
Then?
Okay, but let me explain. This is what I mean. I'm not saying I will not go to these places. I'm not saying I do not go to these places. I'm not saying I do not like these places. What I'm saying is within the first 3 months... You need to show and prove that you are worth me fucking with.
And I'm only worth you fucking with if I take you to an expensive restaurant.
I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is you need to impress me. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately,
what if you the catch?
You said what?
Because in every situation, the woman. What if the man is the catch? Why do I gotta impress you? Why don't you impress me?
The man is not the catch. Because that ain't what the words say.
Nigga, that's what real life say sometimes.
He that find it.
Well, that's not what happens in real life. In real life, everybody
ain't got no business fishing.
No, like for me,
it's easy for a catch to find a wife. Like if you a man with certain money and status, like you can find a fucking wife. These bitches like going to Walmart.
No,
he want to impress you. And
you can find a tar equivalent.
What impresses you?
Okay, so the first date, this is how I go. The first and second date need to be really, really nice. After that, then we can start getting to know each other. You want to meet me at a little bar. You want to go to Starters. You want to go grab a drink. You want to go get some ice cream. Now we can start doing all that other stuff. But I think the first two to three dates need to be impressive.
Who taught you that?
Bad Girls Club Season 2.
Interesting.
Okay, well, my first date with my husband, we met at Champs. Like, he didn't pick me up. We met there. We sat at the bar, we had some drinks, and we ate. And that was technically the first date.
So,
and it was cool.
And I agree.
We didn't even eat a meal.
So all these...
And he did enough to earn date number two.
Listen, yeah. So all these Applebee's... So listen,
it wasn't game.
Yeah, we just had a... You liked this conversation.
You talked to somebody, and there was
the
a connection.
Next time you called and said, meet me somewhere.
Well, the next time he did pick me up.
So
but
listen.
The first time, it was just
for
casual.
All the women out here listening.
The first time, you don't never want to get in a car with no stranger. Stranger
so
danger.
So all the women out here,
you could be the danger.
That's how bitches get end up in trunks.
So all the women out here saying that unless you spend $200, it ain't no date. If you go to Applebee's, it ain't no date. Unless you go to these three high class restaurants, ain't no date. When you see your man at Champs with another lady, don't worry, it's not
a date.
I'm
not saying Applebee's.
I'm saying it's not a date.
I'm not saying Applebee's.
We just having a date.
What I'm saying about Applebee's,
she shouldn't even be in Champs. Is that how she feel about it?
You know what I'm saying? It ain't a date. You see? Any pussy. I will not reward this meal at Applebee's with some pussy.
Man, if all I gotta do is buy food to get the, like,
listen,
food,
I'll take all of y'all to Applebee's
what
now.
What are you talking
about?
I don't expect to fuck.
We can go to Benihana's in motherfucking Dearborn right now, and I can show you a whole table of bitches that's about to bust it wide open for some extra garlic butter.
So you think that's what y'all do? That's
No!
Shit.
Not y'all. That's what they do.
So you the exception or the rule? Are you the exception or the rule?
Exception.
I think I should be the rule, but I think I'm
should
the
be.
Exception.
Okay, so girls, bust it open for Benihana's.
They do it for less than that.
A like, fifth and a blunt.
Back in my really bougie days, like my hood rat
y'all
bougie
setting the bar
days,
really low for women.
Before I got
it's not, we're not setting the bar. We are not the they. They do it. We don't.
Yeah, back in my younger days, I wouldn't, if you ain't spent no money on me or you ain't took me out of town, nigga, you're not saying this pussy. I'm sorry. You just
so who taught you to put a monetary value on your pussy?
Her mama.
Some more.
Oh,
my niggas raised by TV.
That's really raised by comedy.
Niggas raised
coochie
by
coupon.
Coochie
coupon.
But in real life, and I'm not even being funny. What I'm saying in real life, who taught you to put a monetary value on a sexual act? Because that's what it basically says. So your grandma taught you to put a monetary value on
sex. You just heard she got three times for money.
Your grandmother probably did too. Probably taught the females. What does your grandmother call the special place down there? What does she call it? What does she teach
you? I fucking did.
She probably called it a pocketbook. Why? Because it's worth money. A treasure chest, a pocketbook, something like that. Old school, baby. They all taught us that. That's it ingrained. Whether you said it or not, if it's a pocketbook, then it's worth money, right? You hold on to your pocketbook. Don't let nobody get no change. Don't let nobody get no change out your pocketbook.
Or they got crabs in their pocketbook.
Hey, y'all just got to realize
that's a metaphor. Get rid of crabs. It doesn't count. But, if it don't start with an H and I can get rid of it, I
but
never
y'all,
have.
But y'all do know this is a dangerous territory when you basically start putting the monetary value on the sexual act.
I totally agree.
So then when somebody's, when people pay X amount of money and expect a sexual act for it, it's a double, like, if you putting that standard out there that in order to have sex with me, pay this amount of money, I expect
when I
pay this money.
Because I got to run a total in my head once I get to $200. So you know we're going to the Crest Motel.
And
like it's a double-edged sword.
He swear this nigga that took me to Jay Alexander's and we ain't never even kissed. We don't even go there, Dave. For real.
Hold on. Hold on. Because you're trying to throw me out there.
No, because my point is we do.
Are we going to tell the whole truth?
If we do this.
Are we going to tell the whole truth?
We do this as friends. Okay. I would take him to Jay Alexander. We've gone out to eat. I've taken Nina out to eat.
That's my favorite restaurant.
We do things. Right. That's my favorite restaurant.
The shit is great.
But my point is, if that's where I go on a Tuesday just because this is, I'm in the mall, this is where I want to go, or this is what I have a chase for, then you're not impressing me by taking me. What?
So I got a question, because all right.
What?
We clearly
nothing. We're not going to
in the
not here.
In the courting process, we are not talking about we're not.
I'm gonna lose that fight to you. Like I see you looking at me. I'm gonna lose that fight to you. So I don't even want to go down that route because I know what could come out. So I'm just gonna wave the white flag now.
You lost, nigga. We don't take L's on this show.
This one I will take the high road and okay. I will
you know
stay
how
there.
They say it's always that one.
I will take the high road and I'm just gonna stay there. And
all right, man. So here's a question,
Tar. You win.
Here's a question. In the courting process, before you are married, before you are officially girlfriend and boyfriend. I'm just asking the question, okay? I'm going to give my answer. I'm just asking the question. Who should pay for the date?
Whomever ask.
Okay, I'll take that.
The invitee pays.
Okay. What say you?
I'm with her on that one. I've paid for plenty of dates.
Nina?
Not the first two. I don't spend any money until after it's been 30 days. After it's been 30 days, then I'm open to going Dutch.
We're gonna stretch these dates out then. Shit.
Yeah.
That's
but not,
we go on the first, I see you on the 29th.
Yeah.
I just feel like within
we can FaceTime.
You know, like within the first 30 days, you can tell a lot about a nigga. You can tell if that's the nigga you wanna fuck with. You can tell by his spending habits within that first 30 days if he got some change.
Let me tell you something.
You can tell a couple things. So I like to give him 30 days.
See your house and check under your bathroom toilet. Check under your toilet.
Y'all need a new way to check. Because niggas is hip to that. Clean that damn bathroom.
Yeah. Mm-mm.
Be cool for 30 days.
You
like, y'all
know
gotta
if
need
it's been
else.
A one-time cleaning or if it's a way of life. You know a nasty motherfucker. I had a nigga that would let me use his bathroom because that's where all his bitches shit was hid. Like.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like literally.
Use the downstairs bathroom, not the upstairs.
Oh, you know, I'm just nasty. You can't use my bathroom.
Ew, I wouldn't have you right. over.
But his house was clean. So I'm like, this doesn't make any sense. So one day I was over there laying in the bed. His pregnant ass baby mama came and kicked the motherfucking dough in on us. I'm like, oh, God. So I had to almost choke the pregnant bitch. But, you know, that didn't happen.
Okay.
But while they were downstairs arguing and shit, something told me to open that motherfucking bathroom door. And when I opened that bathroom door, it was all her clothes, her pictures. It was
y'all thought y'all was exclusive or something?
Yeah, we have
why
been
you
fucking,
in this shit?
We have been fucking around for it. I was spending the night over there.
Oh. Get
so
out of
so
that
where
shit,
did
though.
You use the bathroom?
It was.
Use the downstairs.
No,
so
they
she
lived,
had to leave out of the bedroom with him. And
what
are
you supposed
there?
To do with her stuff?
They put it in a box or in a suitcase.
It was so much shit. She had been living there.
Let me tell you something. Maybe I'm just a different type of bitch. Please don't move your bitch's shit out the way. I don't want her to know that I was here. Matter of fact, nigga, put her boots back where the fuck they came from. Don't move her shit out the way for
no,
me.
No, I didn't even know this nigga had a bitch. He had told me that he was done with her. He wasn't fucking with her no more. She had
that
pregnant.
He
wouldn't
throw
by
her
mistake.
Stuff out. He can have the stuff in the closet. He didn't want to throw it in the street. Probably a good guy.
He could leave her motherfucking pictures up. Because I don't want that headache no way.
I just felt like he should have told me the truth because when that bitch kicked in that door, I almost pissed myself. I almost motherfucking died.
A pregnant bitch kicked in the door?
Died.
Or did she just use her key and
no,
just swing that bitch
in the
open?
No, door because this nigga lived in them townhouses in Dearborn and over there by Fairlane.
Too specific. Too specific.
Well, if you know, they're like a tri-level. So.
I'm saying no. They don't get a nigga his address. This too
oh,
specific.
He don't live there no more. They didn't move on. But, it's a tri-level, so he had a roommate. His
last
roommate was staying downstairs.
We almost got a cease and desist the last time you talked about shit on
the
right.
Yeah. But his roommate was living downstairs, and his roommate heard the pregnant bitch kicking on the door, so he let the pregnant bitch in. And when she
not
came,
knowing you was upstairs,
no,
busting wide open
no,
for a
he,
real nigga.
He knew I was upstairs. Luckily, we weren't fucking. We was just upstairs talking. Thank God. I had to fight
so he really ain't do nothing
naked.
Wrong, right? Essentially, he just
no.
Had
your roommate
shit.
Shouldn't open the
no,
door.
No, he knew I was upstairs.
I'm saying the guy you was talking to, only thing he did was had some shit in the closet, which is perfectly fine.
No, that nigga had been lying to me like the whole fucking time. And at the time, well, I guess it was just bad karma anyway, because at the time I was engaged to another nigga.
All right.
That don't count.
We done. That's all the questions I have.
The same thing.
No, but I was really about to break off my engagement. Like,
no,
I was.
Then break it off and come holler at me.
Right. Yeah, that's over. I don't have any more questions.
Because I'm the catch. Break that shit off.
I don't like him.
Dame, your catch.
I'm the catch to somebody. To somebody.
This is the last question I got. This is the last one. Somebody said this to me on Twitter the other day.
Sorry, I don't even want to go there with you. Like, I gave up. I gave up. And I don't want to fight with you.
Men gossip more than women.
Oh, y'all do.
Abso-fucking-lu. Y'all know a bunch of bitches.
Y'all do. Y'all try to, y'all don't call it gossip because it's, I guess, maybe shop talk.
Shop talk. Shameless plug.
But y'all do gossip. Shameless plug. Y'all gossip.
Like,
we
bitches.
Don't gossip so, in because the barbershop.
It's not the word. It's not gossip. Y'all just call it talking, okay?
Ooh-hoo. So the statement that says men gossip more than women.
Yes, y'all do.
So what I will say is definitely men talk. I don't think men talk more than women. Y'all talk.
We get more details.
In general. Y'all talk to more random. Every part. Like,
no.
I sit there and listen to conversations from all them people. They'll have the same conversation with four people. Did you know that? And they hang up the phone and had the exact same conversation. They had the exact same conversation. Like, men definitely do talk.
Y'all gossip.
But
I couldn't say that more
than women.
Women
talk more than men in general.
Y'all gossip with bitches. Y'all gossip with other niggas. You gossip with your niggas. You go home and gossip with your girls. Niggas gossip way more than
I take some shit to the grave.
No, and I didn't believe that until
shit to the grave.
I got in this group chat with them two. Damon.
Oh, don't do that.
David gossips Monday through Friday. He takes a break on Saturday and Sunday.
I don't talk to anybody in life. I just don't.
I will say this. I don't know.
This is how it's going to be till we squash this podcast beef or until you give up.
Well, clearly everybody got dirt on you. I'm good over here. Nobody's
guilty by association.
Wait.
Accomplice accessory.
I actually heard that back in the day, like around 96 or 97.
When I was 13 in 96?
Wait. What year did you graduate? You came out in 2000?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, so I did hear that back in the day you were running around dancing at the parties with an S-curl. I
never had an S-curl in my life, and I've never danced. Nothing. I do not dance.
I heard that you used to run around, you know, with the light skins, with the braces, and you used to want to be one of those.
You ain't heard nothing.
Yes, I did, and I heard Godzilla was your favorite song.
I had braids in the 9th grade. I couldn't have I had braids until like the 11th grade.
You got any photos to prove this?
Yeah,
on Instagram. Go look at my 10th grade.
I knew Jay back in high school.
Are you going to do something for us? Can we just see what you used to do at the basement party?
No, we should see what that popping that you was talking about should do. But no, I'm not a dancer.
Can we see a little River Rock action?
I'm not a dancer at all.
Okay. Because I heard that you didn't make the dance club because you couldn't stomach roll.
Oh, God.
What the fuck is this nigga talking about, dog?
It's been a long day, bro. It's been a long day.
What the fuck is going on
here? I heard you were
in
a group. I think y'all were called the Dancing Bears or something like that. Around.
The fuck is what's wrong with you?
He's too young to be a Dancing Bear.
That's a real group?
Yeah. Oh,
who knew?
It's a joke. I said you've been acting real light-skinned. Like,
oh, God.
You be acting like the light-skinned niggas at the auto show back in the day with a guest outfit on.
My bad. I didn't email 20 a lot of fucking songs to put together.
You could have emailed what you had. You could have did something.
I did send some.
Yeah.
Hey, man, I be sleep.
Sound good enough.
This is what I was going to say about your talk about the gossiping. I don't necessarily think that men call it quote-unquote gossiping. I think that's something that men came up with. But I will tell you this, like, case in point. Like, usually in a relationship, if a nigga is messing with another bitch, the other woman know everything about the first woman.
Oh, of course.
Yep.
They pillow talk is too strong. Listen, that pillow talk is a motherfucker. Tell it all. You know all about the ex, all their business, where they work, everything. And I think that men tell more about that than women do.
And that's shit that should not women be usually quiet about it.
I
don't
know. Mm-hmm. I think women pillow talk a lot, and that's how a lot of niggas get out here get killed in the streets, because the woman told the who's fucking with the dope boy.
I don't necessarily think that's pillow talking. I think she's setting that nigga up.
That's intentional. When we say it, we know even what we're
intentional
saying.
Intentional, and you fuck around and halfway got a nigga lined up because you talk too much. Like,
you ain't, no, she knew what she was doing.
I'm telling you, it's happened unintentionally before.
You got lined up in a dad head?
What hell happened? Fuck no. I ain't getting lined up for nothing.
It's a cold world out here, Jay. I done had to jump out a couple windows to save my life. I ain't even going to front.
Yeah. What?
All right,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, I have.
Man.
Give up y'all social media, plug your podcast and all this shit, man. We about to be out of here.
All right. Well, it's Nina. Everyday Ignorance. That's Everyday_ignorance, and that's what I am on Instagram, on Twitter. You can find me at ignorance35. We're also on Facebook at Everyday Ignorance Podcast, so definitely follow us, listen to some episodes. I have a really good one I'm going to put up for Christmas. It's the R&B episode. It's the reason why me and Jason are beefing, so definitely check it out.
There is no beef.
But I was just going to say, Nina, how you beefing with him and he ain't beefing with you? I thought a beef. I mean, I love
him. We're in the same place at the same time. You bought us gifts. No hands got exchanged.
Right. That's my second gift.
All beef doesn't have to be violent.
No, it doesn't have to be violent, but
don't
I thought it
was reciprocal. Don't y'all follow the shade room? And
beef
all
is when your moms ain't safe in the streets. Right. That's what Biggie said.
When you need two gats to go to sleep.
Goddamn right.
Roll no less than 30 deep.
Biggie laid out the rules.
See, what are y'all supposed to jump in there with the other
beef
line?
Beef is they where I see you. Guaranteed to be in I see you.
Yeah, they
I don't know that song like that.
Yeah. Look, they both looking
like that. Born and raised in Southfield.
That was my shit.
Talking about the Southfield, nigga. He right. Just told you.
Born and raised in Southfield.
He just figured good. Your ass. Bow,
bow. How crazy.
All right, Dang.
Oh, Dang Gone Wild. Twitter, Instagram, and motherfucking Snapchat. Yeah.
Jay Johnson 313, Instagram and Twitter. Go to the website, shoptalkpod.com. All the video for the episodes will be there, all the audio for the episodes. And contact, trying to get some advertising. Shoot that email.
Yeah, we won't cuss on your episode and not cuss as much.
Yeah. Next week, Shop Talk Awards, wrapping up. A beautiful year is going to be full. We're going to be 100% fooling.
Yeah.
Judy will be back next week.
This was fun. Thanks for having us.
We appreciate
thank you for coming on. Y'all got some social media information y'all want to get away
I'm
or
Tina
y'all living?
Janelle on Instagram and Snapchat. But I also have, cold pressed juice company called Good Juice. So we are right now a delivery only service, but we're expanding into retail. So you can follow us on Instagram at Good Juice Detroit or on Facebook at Good Juice DET. So all raw cold press juices.
I will be very healthy. Patronizing.
Sounds good. We'll be in Detroit in a retail space very soon.
You got any idea what area of the city? Midtown, downtown?
It's still looking at real estate right now, trying to figure out where we're going to be. What makes the most sense.
Good girl.
Go ahead, Black Girl Magic. Right. Well, y'all don't want to follow me because I don't talk about nothing but Jesus and my son. Because I'm somebody different. I'm saved. Monday through Friday at 7 p.m. It turns off. But no, I'm just TJ. You don't need to follow me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Got you. Also, man, no matter where you listen, if you're listening on iTunes, go and rate the podcast.
Do we access you on iTunes?
If you type in hashtag Shop Talk Podcast, we will come up.
Okay.
It'll be the first one. If you type in Shop Talk Podcast, we'll probably be the last one that comes up. But we come up.
Yeah. But hit the hashtag.
Yeah. If you listen on SoundCloud, you can rate, comment, the whole nine yards. We appreciate all the support, all the love. And as we say every week, I'm not saying we the roc-a-fella podcast, but we are J&J.
Hove.